I was born and raised in the shadow of Devon Horse Show, born in 1934, back when Devon Horse Show was a very humble country event. And I kept coming here over the years and was always interested in horses. And eventually, after going through school, medical school, and 7 years in the military, I got my own horses and started a show here in 1982.
It is probably one of the only horse shows in the United States that is a combined breed show and combined discipline show. And it is rare these days to have such a large show over so many days and outdoors.
It has saddlebreds, hunters, open jumpers. It has all kinds of carriaging classes. So there's every discipline pretty much in horses is represented here.
Devon is one of the oldest horse shows in the United States. It's one of the most prestigious. It's always been bringing entries from all over the country and the top flight competitors of every discipline, driving, coaching, jumping, equitation, saddle horses. We cover all the bases. I mean, this is the place that you come to show the well, as it says, Devon, where champions meet. That's not just a little thing on the wall. It really is very meaningful.
Greatest world champions came here to vie to see who could win a blue ribbon and a championship ribbon at Devon. And to this day, we still have American saddlebreds here coming from all parts of the country to compete and win that Devon blue.
When you talk about Devon, you're talking about not only the competitors, but you're talking about the people, the city of people, not a village of people. It's a city of people who put this horse show on, and they love this horse show. It's part of history. So I love the way the ART comes into the word, because here we are. It's the heart of history in this area. We are so lucky to have had grandfathers and great-grandfathers who were involved in this show and involved in the giving. They are volunteers. They have the heart and the love of what's happening today. And they come back year after year after year.
It's a world-class event. We have Olympic selection trials. We have
Devon Horse Show encompasses the best of America relative to the upcoming Olympics. And the horses here are all prepared to go. The riders are all prepared to go. And the judges that judge them want to see the best and then make their decisions as to who goes. The horse show is 116 years old. Basically, it started out as being a charity for the Bryn Mawr Hospital. Then it changed because the Bryn Mawr Hospital went corporate and tried to sell the horse show. The horse show then bought itself out, and while it still supports the Bryn Mawr Hospital, it also supports some other things.
There we go. They're all captured. Glad everybody's back up.
horse's reaction to fear is flight. And he was afraid because he lost his rider, who was his guidance counselor, and he had no one in the ring that he knew. And so a horse naturally takes flight. And so he ran in fear until he found someone who could reassure him and caught him and told him it was all right.
A moment ago on what would be a truly intrepid Ian Shipley, Redwood, New Hampshire, was the sixth. Seventh award went to number 1887.
To be a rider, it comes from within your heart, your soul, and your bones. There's nothing pretend about it. You just have to have the passion and the love for the animal, and when you have that, everything else kind of comes together in a beautiful way. It's something that you can't explain.
Remember last year it was pouring rain?
This is where all the wonderful carriage riders and people who competed tonight attend a wonderful event to celebrate their success. We are talking about Dr. Don Rosato tonight and all of his achievements.
Don Rosato is a fixture. He is the oldest and most iconic person at this horse show. There's no more charitable, no more gracious, and no more courtly man than Don Rosato. He donates charity rides, carriage rides, to every local charity that you can know, and he keeps on a tradition that so many have lost.
Newport Beach, California. I show hunters and equitation.
I help out with carriages with Dr. Don Rosato. I'm a fox hunter, and I've been coming to Devon for my whole life probably, but I've had a box here for 25 years.
I like all kinds of things that are spectator oriented. It's so enjoyable, and everyone's so hospitable here. So
I agree. I'm from California.
Are you? So there you go. And I lived in California when I worked for Disney for a couple of years.
Well, it's the carriage party for everybody that was carriaging earlier, and we're in the tent having a great time. It's been a good horse show. Really good. Good jumping, great competition, really excellent. It's good to be here.
How are you enjoying the horse show tonight?
Oh, it's fabulous.
What was your favorite event?
Watching Don Rosato get second place in the carriage event.
This is the 117th year of the Devon Horse Show. It actually started off as an event for local farmers to show their livestock, actually. Basically take their horses into the ring, show them, and jump them. And it was a way by which they could sell their livestock. The Devon Horse Show has the greatest number of trophies of any horse show in the world. We have more than 175 trophies that we actually present over to the riders and the competitors during the 10 days of Devon.
This is my very first horse show, and I'm loving it. It's amazing, absolutely amazing.
What was your favorite event?
You know, the jumping, the Grand Prix, because I never really truly realized from watching it on TV how extremely high those jumps are. I loved it. I didn't get that from a TV show.
What did you win tonight? They're all talking about.
Well, I actually took fifth place, I took fifth place in the cones, but the coach I was driving, I just restored in the last 7 months for my lawyer.
Down in hospitality, because I'm on vice of the hospitality. Yes, yes.
Do you know what? They actually, when they presented us, they actually gave us first prize
and second.
And then second prize, but then they came back and they took away our second prize, right?
For theme. We got first for food. They gave us second for theme. Missy did a great job, and she had fabulous judges.
So I think so, too. Is this your first time at the Devon Horse Show, or are you a diehard?
No, I drive a four-in-hand as well.
Did you ride tonight?
I did. I rode on his tonight.
Oh, excellent. Okay.
Right.
Congratulations. And how do you compare Devon to the other horse shows you've been to?
Oh, the best horses are here compared to the West Coast.
Do different barns come here than West Coast?
West Coast comes here, but a small amount. Not everyone.
Small amount.
You have to qualify to be here.
Don. So this is obviously who everybody's talking about tonight. You put on a great show, second place, no faults. What do you have to say about that?
Well, I had all these beautiful women on this, and I was showing off for them.
Showing off.
And I would have gotten a first place, but they were so gorgeous, they distracted me from first place.
You were 1 second away.
There we go.
Yeah.
It's a great institution. I love it. I finished first a couple times, and I finished last several times, and it doesn't matter. It's all great. It has its own momentum. It carries on from year to year, and it does it with great propriety and great stability. And that's one of the things people like about Devon. It's kind of always the same. You can depend on it.
It's a chance for everyone to go and browse their higher-end shops that might be more out in the country, but right here on the main line. There's always the horse and tack shops, and then there's the clothing shops, and the jewelry is what I like. But then there's also a place for the dogs. There's always a place for the dogs at Devon, because everyone brings their dog. It's one of the few venues you can take your dog with you.
Coming here since I was 5 years old. There used to be a Grand Prix open jumper, Idle Dice, who is from here. ridden by an amazing rider, Rodney Jenkins.
Oh my God, that's our trainer. Is one of his favorite riders.
Well, I have goosebumps just thinking about Rodney. My favorite thing is watching Rodney. I mean, and he would always have two or three horses doing the open jumpers, and Idle Dice was one of them. It was a Harry Gill horse, as was Sapphire originally.
Showing at the horse show. It's a wonderful place. People are so wonderful. The customers are lovely. It's just an all-around wonderful time.
This is the Devon Art Gallery. We are just filled with many, many wonderful artists, their showings, and we're having lots of fun selling to the customers that are coming all across this nation just to buy here and enjoying the show at the same time.
When McLain Ward retired Sapphire here, that's a huge honor. It's a two-time Olympic award-winning horse retired in Devon, Pennsylvania, at the oldest horse show in the country, and it's an honor. And Devon Horse Show deserves to be honored in such a manner, and all the riders know that and respect it and appreciate it for what it is.
The training that goes into these horses is multi-years. The horses that appear in this ring have been competing at lower levels and through the levels for 5, 6, 7, 8 years before they can really get to a point where they are competitive at a show like Devon.
And then the last 6 years, my great friend Tom Grossman is here with us tonight. We won another gold medal in Hong Kong, and he was there in a moment. He was there in a moment when it was a chance I wasn't going to get to continue to ride Sarah, and we've had a hell of a 6 years, and Sarah's going to retire to his beautiful blue chip farm, and hopefully we'll have a few babies, and I can't think of a better place for her.
She won't be showing anymore. She's jumped enough.
You don't want to hurt her?
There's only there's only so many jumps in a horse.
Really?
Put it that way. And so she'll have maybe a couple babies that, you know, might
I mean, the horse is kind of young.
She's probably 15. I forget exactly how old she is, but she's young enough to have
in people years.
Yeah. I don't know actually what people, I think four years to 1 year.
So I was just getting what you're saying. She's probably like in her 20s, people years.
Oh, at least, yeah.
Okay.
So, but she can still have babies. They're going to try to have a couple of babies out of her. But, you know, she's traveled around the world. She's schooled and she, you know, it's not just at horse shows she's jumping. You know, she's working all the time, being schooled and educated. And
ladies and gentlemen, let's say goodbye to Sapphire.
Horse is in some cases is smarter than the rider, but normally what makes the horse show here is the fact that you have three different factions working together and pulling together to make it a complete entity.
It can be very challenging when the, you know, you don't have a budget to acquire all of the training and the horse flesh that it takes most of the time. But there are always those diamonds in the rough that you find in a rider and in a horse that can still put it together and still come out in that ring just as much as, you know, a million-dollar combination versus finding that diamond in the rough.
It's always the horse. It's always the horse. But good drivers select good horses. And good horses go better when they have a good driver.
Good boy.